Hello, I'm Roman Nurek from the Android Developer Relations team at Google. In today's DevBytes, we're going to take a look at the new Immersive Mode feature in Android 4.4 KitKat. This feature lets your apps go truly full screen. Let's take a look. So before we talk about Immersive Mode, let's recap all of the different full screen APIs that were available in previous versions of Android. Now, there are two sets of APIs for full screen. The first is a set of window manager flags, such as flag full screen, that you can set or unset to show or hide the status bar. Now, these work on any version of Android and remain active even if you navigate away from your app and then come back. The second is a set of system UI visibility flags. Now, the difference with these flags is that they're only available in newer versions of Android, since about Android 4.0 or later. Additionally, these flags are clearable by the system. So if, for example, you navigate away from your app and then come back, these flags will be cleared and you'll have to reset them. So the first of these new flags is low profile, and this simply dims the status and navigation bars when it's set. The second is the full screen flag, and this behaves basically the same as the window manager flag. It simply hides the status bar. Now, the big one here is hide navigation, which hides the navigation bar temporarily. For those keeping track, the navigation bar is the one that consists of the back, home, and recents buttons, and it's only available on some devices. On some devices, the navigation bar isn't present, and all you would see are soft keys like back, menu, and so on. Now, once the hide navigation flag is set, any interaction with the screen will show the navigation bar, and the touch events that cause that navigation bar to show will not be passed to your app. This is an important point to keep in mind when we talk about immersive mode in just a few seconds. Now, one more point before we move on. There's a bunch of these layout flags that control how your screens are laid out. Setting these flags allow your content to appear behind the system bars. This is especially important when users can toggle the bars in your app. Setting these flags will keep your content from jumping and resizing in response to the bars showing or being hidden. So let's talk about the new stuff. Android 4.4 introduces two new mutually exclusive system UI visibility flags, and they're immersive and immersive sticky. Let's look at a demo of the immersive flag first. So to my left, you see this simple demo app. Now, when we touch the content, you'll see that the immersive system UI visibility flag, along with the hide navigation, full screen, and some layout flags are set. Once you enter immersive mode within an app, to get back to the system UI, you can swipe down from the top of the screen. The system also automatically presents a reminder bubble to the user the first time they enter immersive mode in your app. So here's a quick example of that reminder bubble. Now, an important point here is that your app can now capture all the touch events, allowing users to, say, play an immersive game or scroll through content without the distraction of system bars. So you'll notice here that, you know, first I can actually swipe down from the top of the screen to reveal those bars. And then if I actually start interacting with the middle of the screen, you'll notice that the bars actually stay hidden. And this is the big difference between immersive mode and just setting the hide navigation flag. So one important point here is that swiping from the top of the screen clears those flags. So if you want to, say, hide them again after, say, 3 seconds, you can set up a system UI visibility listener, which we'll talk about in a second, and then 3 seconds later cause a or set the flag again to hide them. So let's look at some code. First, we'll use our Windows root view, or the decor view, as the anchor for system UI visibility. You can use any view so long as it's visible. Now, the next thing you should do whenever you use system UI visibility flags is you should set up a listener to watch for changes. Because the system can actually clear these flags in response to user interactions, you want to be kept aware of when that occurs. Now, in this case, we simply show or hide additional UI controls, such as video playback controls, when the system bars are shown or hidden. And keeping all of your UI controls in sync with the system bars is a best practice to minimize the number of states that your app can be in, resulting in a more seamless user experience. To actually show or hide the system bars, you can either set or remove the right set of flags. To hide the system bars and enter immersive mode, use the hide navigation, full screen, and immersive flags in addition to the layout flags that we talked about before. to show the system bars, just set the layout flags, making sure that the content doesn't jump, and omit the visibility flags like full screen and hide navigation. And what that'll do is that'll actually show the bars. And generally, you'll want to auto-hide the system bars after a period of inactivity. We won't go through all the details here, but basically, you want to use a handler with delayed messages for this purpose. You can also clear messages to make sure that any pending hides or auto-hides are canceled if need be. Additionally, you should handle the case of window focus changes. If you gain window focus, you may want to rehide the system bars. If you lose window focus, for example, due to a dialog or pop-up menu coming up, you'll probably want to cancel any pending auto-hides. So for example, if you're watching a video and you press the action overflow, that shows up a pop-up menu, you'll want to prevent the case of 3 seconds after you show the action overflow, the system bars and action bar hide, automatically closing the action overflow. So this will help you prevent that. Lastly, you generally want to allow users to manually toggle the visibility of the system bars by touching your content, especially if single touches don't do anything else in your screen. To do this, you may think of just using a simple click listener. Now, the problem with this is that click listeners are fired even if you drag your fingers across the content after pressing down. You probably don't want to do that. Instead, you probably want to use a gesture detector, like shown here, and handle the on single tap up event. This makes sure that if your user's finger moves more than just a little bit during the touch, it won't toggle the system bars. Next, let's look at the immersive sticky flag. Now, in this mode, almost everything is the same, except when you swipe from the top of the screen. So here's that demo again, and you see the same bubble. Now, if you swipe from the top of the screen, you'll notice that a couple of things are different. The system bars will show up in a semi-transparent state, as you can see here, and the system bars will automatically hide after a short delay or if the user interacts somewhere with the middle of the screen. Now, the third thing that is different is that the system UI visibility change listeners that you created before will not be triggered, because this state, this kind of temporarily visible system bar state, is intended to be very transient, and your app should basically be completely unaware of this. And last but not least, the system will not actually clear this flag. So when the user swipes down from the top of the screen, those flags will stay there. They won't be cleared. And this gives this flag the sticky name. Now, the code for immersive sticky is really simple. Anytime the window receives focus, simply set the immersive sticky flag along with the other flags mentioned before. Now, you don't have to worry about the system clearing this flag due to user interaction because, again, the flag is sticky. Okay, so let's summarize with some use cases. When should you use these new flags? So if you're building a video player or something else that requires minimal user interaction, you'll want to use something called the lean back approach. And this gets its name from, you know, you start watching or, you know, you turn on the content and you lean back and you don't really do much else with the screen. Now, the lean back approach has been available since Android 4.0. It's been refined in Jelly Bean, Android 4.1, and so on. And it simply involves using the full screen and hide navigation system UI visibility flags. Now, in this mode, in this lean back approach, any interaction with the screen will automatically show the system bars and other playback controls that you've defined. Now, if you're building something like a book reader or a magazine or something that has a little bit more interaction, you'll want to use the new immersive flag in addition to full screen and hide navigation. In this case, swiping up from the top of the screen should reveal the system bars in addition to your own UI Chrome. Lastly, if you're building something truly immersive, such as a game or a drawing app, you may want to use the immersive sticky flag, in addition to the full screen and hide navigation flags, again, as we talked before. In this case, swiping up from the top of the screen will very briefly reveal the system bars in a very, very transient state. So that's immersive mode in Android 4.4 KitKat. Check the video description on YouTube for links to the sample code. Thanks.